हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू साइंस क्लास. नाउ इन प्रीवियस वीडियोस यू वी हैव लर्न अबाउट वाटर, इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ वाटर, यूजेस ऑफ वाटर, देन इवेपोरेशन, कंडेंसेशन, मेनी थिंग्स. सो आई एम बैक विद द चैप्टर 14, वाटर पार्ट 3. सो लेट्स कंटिन्यू द चैप्टर. So in this week, in this part we'll learn about cloud formation and water cycle. In last video also I told you about cloud formation. Again, once again I am telling about clouds formation before water cycle. So cloud formation, first of all, when the temperature of air increases, so what will happen? It expand, because the when temperature of the air increases, it's quite hot, so it expand. It means its particle move away from one another, so this makes the air lighter. If it is hot, it means it is lighter, and lighter things rises in up, and it rises in the atmosphere. And water vapor also there in air, so taking water vapor with it, it rises up in the atmosphere. As the air rises, it begins to cool because of that cool temperature. When it rises up, it begins to cool. The water vapor condenses on dust particles present in the atmosphere. See, in atmosphere dust particles also there. So when air rises up with water vapor, so the water vapor condenses. It condenses, it means water vapor again convert into water droplets on dust particles present in the atmosphere, and when it and to form millions of tiny droplets. Now tiny ice crystals will be formed instead if it is very cold, and sometimes if it is very cold, so instead of tiny droplets, tiny ice crystals will be formed. So these clusters of tiny water droplets floating air is what we called a cloud. Okay, so this is cloud formation. So water droplets in the clouds keep bumping against one another, and sometimes what will happen, sometimes stick to form bigger drops. It means it stick to one another and form a big drops of water. So when these drops become too heavy to float in the air, so they drop down back to the earth. It means when it is very heavy, so air cannot hold this much heavy weight, so it drop down back to the earth as a rain. So the water that comes down as rain in the time evaporates and goes up to form clouds again. Again, what will happen, that when it backs to the earth as a rain, then some amount of rainwater seeps underground, and some amount of water again back to the seas, oceans and rivers. So what will happen again, because of that heat of the sun and all, it gets evaporated and goes up to form clouds again. So this leads to formation of a cycle known as a water cycle. It means again when it goes seas and oceans, again because of that heat of the sun, it gets evaporated and reaches high. Again because of that cool atmosphere, it convert into water droplets, and now water droplets come down as a rain. Again its rain water goes, so this type of cycle going on and on. So this leads to the formation of a cycle known as water cycle. So water cycle means, water cycle is the cyclic movement of water from the atmosphere to the earth and back to the atmosphere through the various processes So any natural phenomenon which repeats itself after a certain period of time is said to be a natural cycle. First of all, natural cycle means any natural phenomenon which repeats itself after a certain period of time is said to be a natural cycle. Okay, so here movement of water is there. So water moves from earth's surface to the atmosphere and back to the earth's surface. Yes, no, when water moves from the earth, it means when water from the earth gets evaporated and reaches to the atmosphere, and again as a rain it comes back on the earth. So water moves of the earth surface to the atmosphere and back to earth surface in a cyclic pattern. So this is called the water cycle. So water cycle involves various processes like evaporation, condensation, precipitation. Thus the water cycle is the cyclic movement of water in the form of vapor from the earth to the atmosphere. Yes, water cycle is the which movement? Cyclic movement of water in the form of vapor from the earth to the atmosphere and back to earth through various processes. See, now first of all, disappearing trick of water. So how many times have you noticed the water spilled on a floor dries? Many times, no? So the water seems to disappear many times, like when we sweeping and swabbing of floor, and after some time that water disappear. So water disappear from our clothes as they dry up. Then water from road, wet roads, rooftop and few other places also disappears after rain when when you see roads, rooftop and some other places also water disappears. Yes, no, so where does this water go? So do you remember that the water evaporated and the salt was left behind? This activity gives us idea that on heating, water changes into its vapor. Yes, so we also realize from this activity that water vapor does not carry away the salt with it. So water vapors so formed become a part of the air and cannot usually be seen. And we also found that heating is essential to convert water into its vapor. So however, we have seen that water changes into vapor is also the field, roads, rooftops and other land areas. We also discussed one chapter also from where water get the heat and needs to evaporate. Here first only clothes drying on a cloth line. When we put that our clothes on a cloth line, what will happen? Water from our cloth gets evaporated, and it means after some time when you see that water from your clothes disappear. Why? Because it gets evaporates. For the one activity I am telling, evaporation of water in sunlight and sand. So take two similar plates, place one of the plate in sunlight and keep the other under sand. Now pour the equal amount of water in both. You can use a cap of a bottle of measure water also. Make sure that water does not spill over. Observe the two plates after two disappear. So from which plate does the water disappear first? What is the source of heat for this evaporation? So you will observe that during the daytime, sunlight falls on the water in oceans, rivers, lakes and ponds. So the field and other land areas also receive sunlight. As a result, water from all these places continuously changes into vapor. However, the salt dissolved in the water are left behind. Okay, so the sand also through it could have taken more time. Why? Because during the daytime, all the air surrounding us gets heated. This warm air provides heat for evaporation of water in the sand also. Thus, evaporation takes place from all open surfaces of water. As a result, water vapor gets continuously added to air. However, evaporation of water is a slow process. That is why we rarely notice its loss from a bucket full of water in sunlight. So evaporation takes place faster on heating water on a burner. Its evaporation takes place even faster. Is there so many other processes there that loss of water by plants? So plants also use a part of water to prepare their food and retain some of it in their different parts. So remaining part of this water is released by the plants into air as water vapor through the process of transpiration. That also you have learned. So do you remember observing transpiration of water by plants? Water vapor enters the air through the processes of evaporation and transpiration. So evaporation means sun's heat changes. So here in water cycle, many processes part of this water cycle. First, evaporation means sun's heat changes the water in oceans, rivers, ponds and other water bodies into water vapor. First of all, in water cycle, first evaporation, sun's heat changes the water in oceans, rivers, ponds and other water bodies into their vapor. Next is transpiration. Plants give off water vapor through their leaves. That you know, you have studied in previous chapter. Next process is condensation. So water vapor rises up and condenses on dust particles to form cloud. Now fourth process, that is precipitation. Water stored in clouds reaches the earth in the form of rain, snow, etc. And last is a collection. So some rainwater seeps into the ground, forming groundwater, and rainwater also flows into streams and rivers and then finds its way into seas and oceans. After that, it back to the oceans. So what happens to the water that rain and snow bring to different region to the earth? So almost all land surfaces are above the levels of ocean. So most of the water that falls on the land as rain and snow, and sooner or later goes back to the oceans. So snow in the mountain also melts into water, and this water also flows down the mountain in the form of streams and rivers, and some of the water that falls on land as rain also flows in the form of rivers and streams. So most of the rivers cover long distances on the land and ultimately fall into sea or an ocean only. And however, water of some rivers flows into lake. So the rainwater also fills up the lakes and ponds. So a part of rainwater gets absorbed by the ground and seems to disappear in the soil. Some of this water is brought back to the air by the process of evaporation and transpiration, as I told you, and the rest seeps into the ground. So most of this water become available to us as ground water. So open wells are fed by groundwater, and groundwater is the source of many lakes as well. And it is also this groundwater which is drawn by a hand pump or a tube well. The more hand pumps or tube well that are used in an area, the deeper we need to dig to find this groundwater, and the loss in the level of groundwater due to the overuse. Now we know that water brought back to the surface of the earth by rain, hail or snow goes back to oceans. Thus water from the oceans and surface of the earth goes into air as vapor, returns as air, hail or snow, and finally goes back to the oceans. The circulation of water in this manner is known as the water cycle. So this circulation of water between oceans and land is a continuous process, and this maintains the supply of water on the land. So students, I hope you understood water cycle, process of water cycle. Now in next video, hopefully I will explain some other topics of the lesson. We'll meet you soon. Thank you.